wideband global SATCOM satellite provides significantly increased capacity to our joint warfighters and Australian international partners. Here in the voice of Steve Agate, providing launch vehicle descent data.
Chamber pressures beginning to decline in the solid rocket motors as expected.
I see it over the tree.
36 seconds, Mach 1, vehicle now going transonic.
Vehicle has now reached Mach 1.
Very stable. Chamber pressure is
traveling at the speed of sound.
As we're passing 45 seconds into the flight. Command 50 seconds, Mark 50 seconds, Max 2, maximum dynamic pressure in the vehicle. Altitude now passing 7 nautical miles. Passing the 1 minute mark. Solid burnout expected about 30 seconds from now. Altitude now coming up on 10 nautical miles. Velocity 3,485 feet per second. Downrange distance 6.9 nautical miles. 1 minute, 17 seconds in. Chamber pressure holding very well on the main engine. Passing 1 minute, 25 seconds. 10 seconds away from solid burnout. Separation. Four solid motors have separated from the vehicle. The Delta-4 rocket only now weighs one half of what it did at launch, expelling propellant at around 1,850 pounds per second. Coming up on the 2 minute mark.
This is Delta
mark,
Mission Control.
2 minutes into the flight.
Delta plus 2 minutes, 3 seconds into the flight. The Delta-4 WTS-4 mission is 2 minutes into the flight. The DVAG has just confirmed jettison of the four solid rocket motors and the mission is continuing as expected. Next event is payload fairing jettison. Scheduled to take place in less than 2 minutes from now. Let's go back to Steve Agate.
Good engine control on the first stage in pitch and yaw. Second stage chamber pressure beginning to rise. Good steady state value in the second stage.